So we have seen a positive uptick in the viewership numbers for ABP. Tell us what do you credit this growth to? And the second part, that we've seen a change in leadership in BARC of late. Did broadcasters sought this change? And how did it help the industry actually?
See, first at ABP News Network, we believe in a philosophy called dramatized reality. So what we do is that we don't take a position on any issue of the day, and we give you the facts in a dramatized and interesting way so that you consume, make your own view while enjoying what we are showing you. That philosophy has helped ABP News Network to achieve a higher milestone in terms of viewership. Having said that, the news also this year has been very newsy. You know, there are so many news coming every single day that people obviously are interested to know what's happening on the street, in the parliament, at the policy level, at international level. So, which has led to the large amount of curious people getting into the web, social media and television. And all put together, we have done extremely well. We invested a lot of money this year in digital and integrated our newsroom. So all our award-winning reporters today also report for the digital medium, which leads to the overall strengthening of the network, which has helped obviously gain the viewership for the channel. As far as BARC is concerned, I don't think so leadership change has anything to do with our rating system. BARC is quite a robust body managed by the industry body of IBF, SSSFI and ISA. And it's in their wisdom that they change the leadership. We have nothing to do with it, or our rating has nothing to do with that leadership change here.
There has been a lot of discussion about how news channels shouldn't be free to air. A lot of broadcasters have mentioned it. What is your take on it?
See, personally, I feel that nothing should be free in this world. Okay, so why news channels? And fundamentally, for a viewer, nothing is free because he is paying 130 rupees plus taxes for subscribing to a set amount of channels for getting that pipe at home. So it's largely between the broadcaster and the DPOs that this free concept is. And considering the length and breadth of the news that we cover, the amount of investment that go in the starting up the business, and it's extremely expensive and hard work required to run the day-to-day news business. For something like this, no news broadcaster should offer it free of cost. We are free-to-air channel right now as a network. Earlier, we were two channel of ours, were pay channel, and we are planning to go pay to other channels. But right now, the general accepted way of working of the broadcast industry and the relationship with the DPO compel a small broadcaster or an individual channel to remain free-to-air because it's not so easy to go pay if you're an individual channel or a small bouquet, and hence we are free to air. But we are certainly looking at option and communicating enough with our colleagues in the industry that all of us should go pay one day.
Right.
According to me, nothing should be free, which people are ready to pay. And also, we can look at a pricing which works for the consumer. If it is benefiting them for their own purpose of knowledge and entertainment, people would be happy to pay for it. So collectively as an industry, we should have confidence to go ahead and ask for money.
We started the year with NTO 2.0, and tell us a little bit about what could the implications of these amendments be on the broadcasters.
See, I would not like to speak on this subject for other broadcaster, but as far as we are concerned, we are a free-to-air channel, and our biggest problem was definition of the geography by the earlier regulation, and because we operate in regional markets, so for a Bengali, if I'm measuring the geography of a Bengali audience, it cannot be all India or the rest of the globe, so which they have defined very clearly in this, the geography part. And also they have capped the maximum carriage fee because most news channels today are become unviable to operate on a regular basis because of the large amount of carriage fee. These channels are solely dependent on advertising revenue, which has also seen a huge dip in the recessionary period that we are seeing since last 6 to 8 months. So it is a step in the positive direction where they have capped the carriage fee and they have defined the geography. So in that respect, it's very, very beneficial for free-to-air news channels. It is very difficult to predict even the next quarter in this environment. But if you're saying to predict for 2020, I think the bigger, larger trend is about digitization of the news content. The more and more smart TV and connected TV people are owning, and TV sales can substantiate the fact that now smaller homes are having multiple TVs, and there are multiple connected TVs, tablets, people are consuming news through different means. So the news has to become interactive, and I think by the year end, news will become interactive at different platforms. Second, the role of AI and the data. Currently, we measure bark on extrapolation. What I'm looking at, that the industry will come together and the government will help us in doing that, is the RPD data to come, so that you actually know who is consuming what. Absolutely. And third one is the merging of the data of consumption at different platforms. So whether you're consuming on social, on the app, on the site, or on the television, it should be combined, because finally you are serving advertising to the eyeballs, and they are everywhere. So I think these three trends will somehow mature for the audience of television news consumption in this year. I'm also looking at the government taking a step towards deregulations, because this industry currently is highly overregulated. Right. There should be more avenues to do business rather than more regulation. And the last but not the least is having the relook at the Cable and Satellite Regulation Act, which prohibits a lot of advertising category from advertising. If it opens up, it will create an opportunity for those manufacturers to advertise, and it will give a breathing life to the news broadcast industry.
Thank you so much. Those answers were really insightful. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.